In this table, we are going to compare and contrast different antibiotics, basically about the penicillin, cephalosporin, carbapenem, vancomycin, and ciprofloxacin. So penicillin, you can see the antimicrobial, right? The broad name of antibiotic is called penicillin, but the example is penicillin itself, amoxicillin, and ampicillin. Penicillin is a narrow spectrum, but amoxicillin or ampicillin is a broad spectrum. What does it mean? Narrow spectrum means they can work against gram-negative bacteria. But the broad spectrum means they can work. It works against gram-positive and gram-negative both, right? So what we could know about this group of drugs, what are the side effect and keynote for NCELX board? First of all, in these five groups here, the second is called cephalosporin or cephalexin, cefazodin, and ceftriaxone, right? This group are cephalosporin group. And third one is called carbapenem and imipenem. We use this one serious bacterial infection. And another antimicrobial or antibiotic we use for serious infection called vancomycin. Vancomycin, basically aminoglycoside group antibiotics. Last group here, ciprofloxacin, right? And basically the name is called fluoroquinolone, the group of drugs. So penicillin, if you give your patient, you can tell them about the side effect. So penicillin, cephalosporin, carbapenem, and cipro all can cause GI upset. GI upset, you see? Carbapenem can cause GI upset, and ciprofloxacin also called GI upset. The penicillin or cephalosporin or carbapenem, they can cause allergic reaction like dyspnea or skin rash. So it is easy to remember penicillin, amoxicillin, ampicillin, or cephalexin, cefazodin, or imipramine, everybody can cause allergic reaction. But again, I said, patient will come and say, I have an allergic reaction, not like this. When you give this group of antibiotic, if you can see, patient has a shortness of breath, or dyspnea, or any kind of skin rash, it indicates they have a allergic reaction. So penicillin not only can cause nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea, they also can cause super infection like candidiasis. Also, they can cause renal toxicity. So if your patient, after taking this medication, if the urine output is go down, it indicates they develop the renal toxicity. What are the keynote for this group of patient? What are the keynote I said? Do not give to the patient if they have allergy to penicillin or cephalosporin. So when you take the history you must take the history about the allergy. So if they have an allergy to penicillin or cephalosporin, we never ever give them penicillin, right? Let me recap something or some note about the NCELX board. When we give them their penicillin, first ask about the history for allergy. Also ask about any kind of reaction such as itching, rash, or hives. Do not give if any reaction has occurred in the past. But good point is here, the penicillin safe for pregnancy. So pregnant mother can take the penicillin. The first time a patient, if take the penicillin as a LPN or RN, we have stay with the patient at least 15 minutes, just like blood transfusion, to check any kind of reaction occur or not. Allergic reaction, if patient developed because of penicillin, we give them antidote. Antidote is called epinephrine. If you compare with aminoglycoside, like erythromycin or gentamicin, antidote is called calcium gluconate. But penicillin antidote is epinephrine. We educate the patient to take this medication for full prescribed length, right? Do not stop if the symptom is disappeared. So if they start the antibiotic, they can continue whole course, right? So it is not too good to stop suddenly. What next? Next group here, cephalosporin. The cephalosporin member are cephalexin or cefazodine or ceftriaxone or ceftazidine or cefadoxin, so many. So this group of drugs has some side effect. They can cause diarrhea or nausea, vomiting, I mean GI upset, or they can cause furry tongue. Furry tongue means blackening of the tongue. And also we can check the liver function test because sometimes they increase the liver enzyme. So also the cephalosporin effect on central nervous system like seizure, lethargy, or depression, especially ceftriaxone cause. Okay. So what are the note every student must know about cephalosporin, right? Do not consume alcohol during the therapy. Also take with food. So cefazolin or ceftriaxone, good to take with food and never ever take with alcohol. Let me recap something about cephalosporin. So the side effect, it is they can cause hyperglycemia. So if your patient have a diabetic, tell them to monitor the blood sugar level because cephalosporin can cause hyperglycemia. They can cause anaphylactic shock if any allergic history or insufficient platelet count, and this is called thrombocytopenia, or they can cause renal problem, we call nephrotoxicity, right? As like as penicillin, if cephalosporin overdose or toxicity occurred, we give them antidote. An antidote name is epinephrine, same as like a penicillin. So penicillin and cephalosporin, if overdose occur, we give antidote, and this name is epinephrine. So now go next group. Next group here, carbapenem and imipenem. So these two medication we use for serious bacterial infection. They have a side effect like penicillin and cephalosporin, GI upset, allergic reaction, or super infection like cephalosporin, especially yeast infection. What are the notes we have to know about them? Patient, if allergy to penicillin, patient if allergy to cephalosporin may have allergic reaction to carbapenem. So if patient have any history of penicillin allergy, cephalosporin allergy, it is good not to give them carbapenem or imipenem. You have to choose different groups of antibiotics. The other group here is called vancomycin. Very important and very popular medication, vancomycin. So vancomycin is a very powerful antibiotic we can use to treat meningitis or infective endocarditis, or we can use septicemia. Vancomycin also can use clostridium infection. Vancomycin has some side effect. They can cause, you see, ototoxicity, renal toxicity, infusion reaction, or inflammation of the vein, and is called phlebitis. So when you give the vancomycin, you can check the patient needle site. If you see any redness, swelling, increase the temperature, it indicates they develop the inflammation, right? So here we go. Phlebitis we can check, or infusion reaction we will check. So also we could monitor the blood level of vancomycin, right? Monitor the blood level of vancomycin. The last medication here, antibiotic here, ciprofloxacin. Basically, the ciprofloxacin is a member of fluoroquinolone, shortly called Cipro. Ciprofloxacin we use for bacterial infection or respiratory tract infection or anthrax. Also, we can use for urinary tract infection. Okay. What are the side effects? They can cause GI upset, right? Also, frequently, NCELX board asks this question. They can cause tendo-Achilles rupture. Everybody know the calf muscle. The calf muscle where ending in the heel, this area is called tendo-Achilles. So ciprofloxacin can cause tendo-Achilles rupture. They can cause superinfection, photosensitivity. Also, we can tell your patient to wear the sun protect lotion. So let me recap one more time about the side effect or keynote of ciprofloxacin. I said ciprofloxacin can cause photosensitivity. So it is good to avoid the sunlight, right? Or wear the sunglasses and lotion. They can cause GI upset. It means nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. So it is good. Sometimes the ciprofloxacin with this medication can cause a false positive on urine drug skin. will show for opioid. In case of children, there is a certain these drugs may cause arthrotoxicity, very uncommon. So this is the antibiotics we learn here for NCELX board.